Good afternoon and welcome to this week's edition of Homepage, your computer and internet show. I'm David Onley, and coming up on today's edition of Homepage, a look at the highlights from the Consumer Electronics Show in Los Angeles. We have an exclusive report, a demonstration of a new device that puts the lid on spam. And if your company's being hammered by it, then you want to pay attention to that one. And new software that can help you plan your vacation in a way you've never been able to do before. And don't forget to call us with your questions or comments. Our resident computer expert, Jim Sanderson, will be joining us later on in the show. But first, a first on City TV tomorrow night, Mission Impossible 2 will be able to be seen on high-definition television, the wave of the future. And joining us now with a look ahead is Stephen Tapp, Vice President and General Manager of City TV, and Bruce Cowan, Director of Broadcast Technology for Chum Television. Welcome to the program.
Afternoon, David.
I barely know where to start with this because there's a technological side and there's a big, sexy, juicy, exciting aspect to it as well. And Stephen, so let's start with that. I mean, HDTV, it is the way of the future.
I think it's the greatest invention since color TV, okay. Put it that way. It's going to provide our viewers with some of the most incredible, vivid pictures that exist today in the industry. It's a massive technological leap forward for us to get into HD at this early stage. And we're doing it because we want our viewers to have the very best signal possible in their homes. And Bruce can take us through the technical reasons why HD is so much better. But I'll tell you, we're doing it for our viewers, and it's City TV will never look so good.
Yeah, well, we've always been on the cutting edge, so no exception here. And I guess, Bruce, when we look at the big plasma screen right here, I mean, that's just the shape of it, that's kind of the start piece of understanding HDTV.
It's certainly the thing that jumps out at you right away, David, is the shape of the image, which we refer to as widescreen or 16 by 9. A traditional image like you're watching now on CP24 is a 4 by 3 image, and that's
right.
That's the ratio of the screen size.
That's the way it's been for decades.
For 50 years.
50
actually,
years. Wow.
The pictures we see today were actually designed and developed by the NTSC committee 50 years ago.
Wow.
Amazing.
That is. Now, over the years, especially in the last few years, we've been seeing more and more programs. Enterprise is one of them that we see in the letterbox format. I take it they're getting ready for HDTV themselves. Anytime you see that for a TV show right now, they're saying, hey, you know, we've got to be HDTV ready.
Exactly. A lot of those shows and movies, of course, have been shot on film. And traditionally, they are shot in a widescreen type of format. And some of those, as they migrate to standard definition television, we start to see those in a letterbox format. And today also certain shows are shot in letterbox, more for that artistic view.
We've got a promo that we've been running here in the station. George Lagatanis put his considerable talents together, and let's take a look at it right now.
HDTV, high-definition television. You've heard a lot about it, and now this Thursday at 9, City TV is proud to be the first station in Toronto to bring it to you as we present Mission Impossible 2 exclusively on Rogers HD Channel 286. If you've already got an HDTV set, you'll still need a Rogers HD terminal. City TV in HDTV. Catch it on Rogers Channel 286, Thursday at 9 p.m.
It's neat. That is very, what a great movie to
Hey, Tom
launch
Cruise
with.
Never looked so good, man, I'll tell you. This is a really hot movie, and it's a great first for us to launch such an action-packed movie like that in high definition, because the viewers are really going to get a sense of the, you know, and appreciate the difference between high def and regular analog delivery of the signal.
Now, what if you're on Bell Express View?
Yes, we've just as of yesterday signed a deal with Bell Express View as well to run this movie on their high definition channels as well. So, and in the coming months, we'll be adding more cable systems and perhaps other satellite providers as well.
Now, Bruce, if someone's saying they're all excited now and they're setting their timers and everything, what happens if they go to Bell Express View or Rogers tomorrow, but they don't have the proper HDTV set or equipment? What happens then?
If you do not have an HDTV set-top box or decoder, you actually will not have access to the HD channel. It's a premium service that you would have to subscribe to.
You'll still see it on City TV.
That's correct.
As you would
That's correct.
All the other.
Yeah, we'll be simulcasting effectively. We'll have on our regular City TV channel, Channel 7, on Rogers Cable or any other cable system or satellite system across the country. And we'll also be simulcasting on the high definition channel. So if you don't have a high definition set or box, you won't see anything on those high def channels. But you'll see the regular City TV feed.
Now, Bruce, as well, I mean, people are not generally aware of this, but I mean, right now, there is a signal that's being broadcast over the air.
Well, that's correct, although it's not right now. Actually, beginning Monday, January 20th, we will begin testing phase of our over-the-air service, which is a digital signal on channel 53.
Wow.
And that's, we will be in a four-week test phase before we initiate a full-blown official launch of the programming. And actually, during this test phase, one of the requirements that we have by Industry Canada is that if anybody's experiencing any interference due to the new signal, they should by all means contact me. I'd like to hear about any potential interference, and they can get a hold of me at the main switchboard number.
You know, we've only got a minute left. We could spend another half hour easily going over this, but is there any way, I mean, you talked about it as the biggest innovation since color TV. When you see it at the store, it's at least that.
It's the wow factor.
It is wow. I've
had a high-def set and a Rogers high-def decoder, as Bruce, in my house for the last year. And it has really transformed the viewing experience. I mean, there's so many great technological innovations in the cinema and on DVD and that kind of thing. And it's about time that television viewers have the opportunity to take advantage of these great innovations. And it is like being there. I mean,
don't forget the audio, too.
Absolutely.
Yes. It offers the potential of 5.1 surround sound audio. That experience is fantastic as well. That won't be on tomorrow night's movie, but that will come.
Bruce, this is the infancy of it, but we know federal regulations in the states. I mean, they're being mandated to have sets that are HD ready just within the next few years. What's television going to look like 10 years down the road, you figure?
Fortunately, the pictures will get better, and the sound will get better as well, and television will become more interactive through program guides, as you'll be able to look through the information and more options in terms of audio. The television is going to look like this flat panel display on your home as opposed to the larger type of set. You'll have a much better viewing and more like a theatrical experience in your home.
I'll say that most producers as well will be producing in the high-def format.
Yes.
And that's the big issue right now. We want to get as much content produced originally in HD format as opposed to up-converting it to the HD signal. And that's going to be something that you'll see in 10 years. You'll see pretty much everybody will be shooting and producing it in the HD format, which will be really spectacular for the viewer.
You get a sense that this is going to be the great dividing point, just so as you look back into movies in the 40s and then into the very late 30s, there's that qualitative change that suddenly hits, like with Gone with the Wind and that type of a time frame. From there on in, everything is visually different.
One gets a sense. Defining moment.
Yeah.
And Chum is really proud to be the first Canadian broadcaster to receive a digital license and to run Mission Impossible 2 tomorrow night. Is a first for a Canadian broadcaster in high definition.
Guys, thanks so very much for being with
You're
us,
welcome.
Stephen Tapp, Bruce Cowan. We'll look forward to it tomorrow night.
You bet.
Thank you. Don't forget, Homepage is interactive. We'll be answering your questions just a little bit later in the show. Now, today, two callers can win a prize, a copy of Information Technology Transactions by Duncan Card, one of today's guests, and a Game Boy Advance game. We'll have a report on that in a minute. Winners must come to the station to pick up their prizes. Here's how to reach us by email. It's homepage at pulse24.com. By phone, it's 416-872-CP24. Long distance, it's 1-888-863-CP24. Time for a short break here on Homepage. When we come back, keeping a lid on spam.